Okay, let's begin to look at each of our data quality metrics in a little more detail. We'll start by looking at the validity metric. Here, we're primarily concerned with individual field values. For example, we might have fields that are mandatory. There must be a value there. We might have fields that must have a unique value within each data item. We might have fields with foreign key constraints. An example might be product records, each of which must have a reference to a manufacturer, and that manufacturer must exist in our database. We might have cross-field constraints. What I mean by this is essentially conditions on multiple fields. So for example, the start date must come before the end date. Now for most fields, we're also going to be expecting a specific data type or a particular structure of some kind if we're talking about JSON data, where fields can have values that are themselves dictionaries or arrays. We might also have fields that we expect to have a particular pattern, a pattern that we can test using regular expressions. Some fields will have values that we expect to be in a certain range. This might be a numeric range that we can do bounds checking for, or we might be talking about set membership of some kind. So all t-shirts have to have a size field that's small, medium, large, or extra large. Auditing validity is about determining what the constraints are on individual fields and checking to ensure the field values adhere to those constraints.